keynote speaker, Mr. Rohit Gothi, CEO Hero Cycles Limited. He will share his thoughts on why purpose before profit is very important to stand strong in future. Now, Rohit Gothi is leading one of the largest cycle companies in the world as its CEO. He has been at the helm of this global company since the last 3 years and has ensured not only Hero continues to grow and stays the undisputed market leader that it is, with almost 43% share in India, in Indian market itself, but also grows the premium bicycles market in India through Firefox Bikes Limited and the European market through its UK subsidiary, Avocet Sports Limited, Manchester. Ladies and gentlemen, I want all of you to join me in welcoming with a virtual applause over to you, Mr. Gothi. A very warm welcome to you.
Thank you. Thank you, Khati. A very good afternoon to all. To all who have been able to join and to all who will be joining very, very soon. Anurag and his team over the years have created a brilliant organization. And over the last 24 hours, I've been witnessing some very, very interesting conversations around this conclave. So it's a real pleasure to be presenting to this audience. And thank you for inviting me to share my thoughts. And the conversation came around, what should I be sharing? And there were some options which were given. I think I immediately chose purpose before profit, because that's something which is absolutely relevant, that's timeless. In the current context, that becomes extremely important. I'm going to just share a presentation slide for all of you, so that becomes convenient.
Yes.
So yeah, as I was sharing, when I was given some choices of on what I want to speak upon, I think purpose before profit really, really, I thought is the most relevant topic to speak upon in the context of our brand Hero. I'll try and share this for the next 25 to 30 minutes, my presentation, and then I will be more than happy to take any questions on any of the thoughts which I'm sharing. All of us know, I'm sure most of the people would have heard Simon Sinek. There's no better masterclass than what purpose, why of any brand. And to me, he beautifully defines why it is extremely important to have why for the brand, and why is nothing but the purpose. Over the last few months, we have seen some different ways of working. I thought I'll just share some of the screens from our place of working. This is a screen where these are our team members, our partners, distributors, dealers, and we're just celebrating Diwali. You know, and I would have never thought that. Typically, what we do is once in a year, we kind of 3,000 people meet in a gathering across the country and celebrate Diwali. This has been a tradition which we have been doing for quite a few years now. And this year, we're just not able to do it. But we said, no, we have to do it. So we kind of, you know, obviously pivoted around virtual, did some various kind of fancy dressings and Diwali gifts, virtual gifts. So this is the kind of change which all of us are seeing, you know. Obviously, we are also seeking balance in our lives. The left-hand side is a favorite shot of mine where people are cycling. So how do we live in the new normal? Basically, we are all seeking balance in this year more than any time. And then at the same time, we are trying to reevaluate our operating ways, both at an organization and more importantly at an individual level. Trying to multitask because suddenly work from home is what we are forced to do. So all in all, there has been a fundamental shift during the year, in the last few months, and that has made us very, very humble. You know, one feeling which I always now, whenever I interface with the employees, with my partners, whenever I go to the factories, I'm seeing there is a sense of humility which has come into us as human beings, which was possibly not there. There was this sense of arrogance that we can overcome anything. But suddenly a small microbe comes and really disturbs the entire ecosystem in a way. So we have become very, very responsible to some extent, absolutely more socially responsible, more sensitive to nature, more aware of our surroundings. I'm sure most of us remember the face of the local Kirana now, even with his or her mask. And more importantly, I think over the last 9 to 10 months, quite a few of us actually have started looking inwards, which means we're trying to find out what our real calling is, what our real purpose is, what is our sense of purpose, what is our ikigai. I mean, there are various words. But overall, it has also told us that how unprepared we are, in spite of all the scenario building which we are doing in the corporate world, in spite of various risk matrices which we as an organization try to create. It has told us that we are not prepared. Similarly, as a consumer, and all of us are consumers, we are seeing a definite shift. Words like social responsibility, inclusiveness, which earlier used to have lower weightage in the so-called purchase preferences, have become suddenly become extremely important. We as consumers are trying to spend less, but we are also seeking value for money. We actually are looking at categories first, categories which are socially responsible, categories which are having an environmental impact, and then go to the brand. So the hierarchy of decision making to a large extent has changed, where categories become more important than the brand. Earlier we used to think of what brand to buy, now we think more category to buy. And these are fundamental shifts which are happening in the consumer behavior. We are also wanting our institutions to do more. Suddenly, our expectation from our own governments across the globe have increased manyfold. We are looking up to the institutions to lead us. We are looking up to the brands to lead us. We want brands to be an example and guide us through this change. We want brands to make us more optimistic about the world which is around us. We want brands to really, really demonstrate that this crisis can be fought and innovate accordingly so that we can live in a much better world. So overall, the Gen Z, which usually, and which what we have seen in consumer behavior is, which has been doing it for the last 4 or 5 years, the latest, I mean, that's the trend we are seeing in this generation as a consumer cohort, that they're anti-capitalism, if I might say so. And this set of consumers suddenly have found a new voice. And this gives an opportunity to brands, to corporations, which are being seen by these set of consumer cohort as capitalist, actually, that we can actually redefine capitalism. And we can actually seek much more acceptance from this generation. Because this generation believes that, to a large extent, again, and I'm not generalizing, I'm not talking about the entire generation, but we're talking about trends here, that large corporations are typically profit-making machines. And in their quest of profit, they create huge imbalances in the environment and the world of tomorrow. And this is the time when, in general, as I said earlier, we are being much more humble. The brands are becoming much more humble. There is a humility around the brands. We can actually speak to this set of consumers convey to these group of consumers our real purpose, and I'm sure we can win back these set of millennials very, very soon. It's not that the baby boomers were not wanting the brands to be change agents. They were also to some extent, but here we are talking about degrees. Especially with COVID, especially with this pandemic, virtually every second person is expecting brands to be much more responsible towards environment and societies. In fact, over the last few months, if you look at any data, you know, being responsible is a much demanded expectation. Earlier, it used to be nice to have, whether you are being responsible towards your society, your environment, your employees. Suddenly, it is becoming it is a much demanded expectation in the last 1 year, and that's a significant change event we see when we speak to the consumers, when we speak to our own employees, or when we speak to any of the our trade partners. They are saying that, look, we always wanted all brands to be responsible, but today the threshold of being responsible has increased, and therefore it's extremely important that as a brand, you not only tell what your brand positioning is, you don't only tell what your brand is going to play in which consumer cohort, but very, very important, what is the purpose of the brand and why is this brand exist? We have seen many, many emerging dialogues of purpose today. Now, some of them could be pure marketing communication gimmicks. But at the same time, the brands are doing some innovation to talk to the consumer in an innovative and interesting way. And I mean, like, let's accept the fact that business was and is never about profits. When I say business was never about profits, it was never about maximizing profit. Making profits is extremely important. The CEO of this organization, whenever I go to into a board meet every quarter, I have to meet my profit targets. But that does not mean that I have to meet only my profit targets. Profits cannot be the purpose. Think of any successful entrepreneur. Think of Mark Zuckerberg. I'm pretty sure that when they started the business, they never thought that we are going to make profits. They started those businesses, they started those enterprises because they were passionate about those things. Profit follows. But the why to them was extremely clear, that why are they getting into these businesses? At Hero, and as I come back to our journey of Hero brand, I mean, it's so beautiful. We started our first bicycles rolled out in 1956. And there is a folklore in the company, and its folklores usually, you know, are based on what the facts were at some point of time. And obviously, I was not there. But when you speak to people who have been there around in this organization for long, when you read books about us, and there are many books which are written about Hero Cycles journey and the Munjal brothers who were the founders of this particular corporate. I mean, it's interesting that they were absolutely passionate about one thing, and that one thing was, how do we move this country who has just got its independence? Think 1956, the penetration of two-wheelers and four-wheelers was very, very low. And at that point of time, the founding fathers of this particular brand thought that this is our passion, this is our purpose. And that purpose is that how can we give wheels to this post-independence India? Obviously, they never put these words, which I am now trying to look back and connect the dots. But if you speak to the current chairman of this organization, his father actually started this company and this brand. And you hear that he was very, very clear that what I'm doing is I'm not making bicycles. What I'm doing is I'm providing mobility to our countrymen. In our factory, people like me who have come from various different backgrounds, at some point of time you say, why can't our margins be much higher than what they are? And there's a literal pushback from everybody saying that no. First and foremost, are we surrendering true to our values of durability, reliability, and affordability? These were some of the values when we started. And there is reason to these values, because at that point of time, think 1956, think 1960s, you know, it was not that India's growth momentum was as it is today. The penetration of two-wheelers, Hero motorcycles started much later. It was primarily cycles which were moving the countrymen, especially in tier 2, tier 3 and rural India. And therefore, we were very, very clear that when we make the bicycle, we will never, at least from our standards, try and maximize profits. But we will keep the profits fixed. So whatever innovation on material we will do, whatever innovation on freight cost, whatever innovation on logistics, whatever innovation on material, whatever innovation on design, whatever innovation, any cost savings, anything to do with our supply chain partners, we shall pass on that particular set of margins to the end consumer, so that the penetration of bicycle improves in the country and it really helps our citizens to move. I mean, and it was not only that, you know, it was the purpose. The brand always remained true to its purpose, and with evolving country, it steered alongside. Whether it was talking about women empowerment at some point of time in 1970s, or ensuring that most of the parts and the components of the cycles and the brand was made in India, and I'm talking again 60s and 70s, just try to think of those time. The brand remained always true to its purpose of moving the country, of moving citizens from point A to point B as the preferred mode of transport. These are some of the earlier campaigns. You're trying to look at the archive book and see what we were doing to being true. And every time you see something like this, it was very, very clear that the brand purpose was very clear. It was always giving accessibility to all its users across segments. I mean, this is much later. We realize that there are these ASHA workers in villages who need a special type of bicycle to go and really take care of the, and this is 80s now, and this is 90s now, not 70s and 60s. So obviously the team kept on creating with innovating with consumer needs and created products with the whole purpose that we are here to move India. And these ASHA workers who are also kind of half nurse, if I might say so, help them to really move from one place to another in order to help the country. So very clearly the purpose of the brand through the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s and 90s was and is mobility. And what a journey, an incredible journey it has been for Hero Cycles. Not only we became India's number one bicycle brand, but as I speak, we are the world's largest selling brand in terms of volume. And therefore, this journey has been incredible. Go to the villages, and again, very, very focused on the purpose that we are here to move you. And in the process, as you move from a place, let's call a Bau Bazaar in West Bengal, 10 kilometers in that place, instead of going in a shared auto, your earnings of this particular lady will increase, and at the same time, she will create her own asset by buying through a finance company. I mean, we have tapped with most of the NBFCs, and we really, really go in deep rural to ensure that we are being true to the purpose. As I keep on saying, profit has never been about shares at Brand Hero. It's about playing a meaningful role in the society. And one thing about this whole cycling, you know, over the last few days, and people who are in Delhi would relate to it. If you go to India Gate, you can see a lot of consumers, a lot of people coming and actually enjoying bicycling. And in one of those consumer insight immersions, which we were doing at India Gate, one statement, and that statement I thought I must share with the group. We asked them why, I mean, what is the great thing about cycling? And she said, the exhilaration I feel when the wind touches my face is no machine of any horsepower can ever give me that joy. When I heard that, and then I was reading somewhere about a statement which Fareed Zakaria made, and he said that, and I can relate to that when this consumer said, and the statement which Fareed said, that in these times more than ever, especially when digital and digitalization is taking over virtually everything, we will cherish the things in us that are most human. And I said, there cannot be more human thing than a wind touching your face when you're cycling. So that's the brand we are trying to create, which is having a purpose, but at the same time have a soul. As things move to 90s, to 2000s, to the current pandemic, we pivoted. We pivoted because we realized the society needs a different push now. We pivoted from mobility to sustainable mobility. We realized that the kind of pollution, the kind of damage or the carbon emission which is happening in this country, it's extremely important that a brand like Hero Cycles, who has been kind of having the purpose of moving India, now has to take a larger purpose of sustainable mobility. And that's what now, for the last 2 to 3 years, we are trying to achieve, that our purpose now is not only sheer mobility, but sustained mobility, which is much more responsible way of doing mobility. All of us know that, if one person uses a Hero Cycle instead of a car, almost 1.5 tons of carbon dioxide can be offsetted by one particular cycle. All of us can see the pictures here. The kind of decongestion usage of Hero Cycles can do. I mean, data says very clearly that the congestion can actually reduce by 400%. So what we said to ourselves is that, can we take a larger, higher order purpose norm, which is that, can we reduce carbon emission by X percentage? And we said, yes, why not? And we did studies. There were a lot of studies we have done with various partners. And the data is very, very interesting. And the data says that if 40% of the commuting traffic, which is less than 7 kilometers, moves to cycle, it can actually contribute to 1.1% of the country GDP. And obviously the benefits will come in terms of health, which is reducing pollution. The benefit will come in terms of India being much more fitter. The benefits will come in terms of India being more healthier. So that's what we are seeking. And that's the purpose of our brand Hero now, that how can we create a brand which is absolutely, absolutely efficient for future commute, with a very clear vision of achieving a clean India, fit India, and move India. Over the years, we realized that the black cycle, the Hero, classical Hero, is helping India to move. We quickly said to ourselves, okay, we have moved a particular movement there, almost 5 crores bicycle, which translates roughly into 20 crores, 25 crores of households. We have been able to give bicycles to commute. How can we now convert more and more two-wheelers and four-wheelers into electric journey? So we launched a brand extension called Hero Electro. This is an electric bicycle which we launched. And very clearly, the whole purpose is that, how can we migrate most of the people into this category of e-cycles from motorcycles or from cars. Most of you who have been to Europe would have seen the kind of penetration e-cycles have done there. It is actually the largest selling category now in terms of EV. So if in Europe, if you see the number of EVs, four-wheelers, two-wheelers and e-cycles, you realize e-cycle is the largest selling category there. Obviously, there are reasons there and I'll cover that. But we said as a brand, this is our purpose should be now to create a cleaner India, a fitter India. So what we said, let's segment our brands. So there is a brand called Hero Cycles, which will take the journey of Move India. We have brands like Hero Sprint and Firefox, which will take the journey of Fit India. And then we have Hero Electro, who will have a very, very clear focus purpose of converting this country into an e-country or a clean India. Let me just show you a quick video of what this electric bike is all about and what are we doing with that. This is a bike which we launched around 2 years back. This is completely electric.
Yeh life apne kyun ho rahe? Time ko the time kar slow down pace. Time to heal body and soul. Zindagi ki cycle how to roll. Life is a cycle.
So this is the our initiative to keep our brand purpose absolutely relevant to all set of consumers. This is an e-bike. We realized that we need to kind of refresh our brand Hero, and then we launched Hero Electro. Not only we quickly innovated to launch an EV, which is, you know, one of the issues with any of the electric vehicles and the adoption of electric vehicles in India has been the charging, that you need to create a charging infrastructure before actually you can bring in two-wheelers and four-wheelers. So we said, okay, there are so many mobiles in this company, in this country, which can be charged immediately. So we quickly take the technology, put lithium-ion batteries into these e-cycles, and now they can be charged at any household, you know, so they don't need charging. We believe this, along with various government initiatives, and if you're able to facilitate the ecosystem for safe cycling, I think this can really, really create a huge difference to the country, especially in these times when we're realizing that what kind of imbalances, if there are any imbalances which happen in the ecosystem, what kind of pandemic actually it can cause. So that's what we are trying to pivot ourselves. The purpose we are saying why we exist today is for sustainable mobility. We need to invest in futuristic manufacturing facilities. We have invested quite heavily. In fact, in the last 7 months, when the entire world was contracting its capex, we were possibly one of the few companies and brands who are investing in setting up a new factory. We want to be the thought leader very, very clearly. We have almost, I mean, the e-cycles, we have 80% share. On bicycles, Hero has almost a 42-43% market share. But more importantly, we want to continue to be a thought leader. Ease of adoption, wider distribution, service network. This is a product at the end of the day. Now people are using it as a solution. So from product to solution, that journey of ease of adoption with respect to service network, with respect to financing options. More importantly, how do we facilitate the ecosystem? As a brand, you might have a purpose, but then some purposes might not be achieved on your own. And therefore, we said we need to facilitate the ecosystem. Over the last many months between us, me my chairman, we have been engaging with the government, be it Niti Aayog, be it various ministries, to actually tell them the benefits. You know, what happened over the last 9 months, suddenly the roads were empty. All of you would have seen that, right? And naturally that roads were filled by bicycles. So very clearly, if you make the roads empty, and obviously you can't do that, but if you create dedicated lanes for cycles, then you can actually inspire of a cycling movement, a cycling brand into this company. So that's what we are saying. We can actually inspire a huge movement through our brand Hero Cycles. We can create cycling tracks. We are, in fact, in two cities, we are investing along with the local bodies to create those cycling tracks. And how do we then facilitate the ecosystem by advocating and championing the policy level changes? So that's the overall frame. I'm not talking about brand sharply here because I wanted to share the overall ecosystem of what Hero Cycles is doing. And actually, more than ever, our brand commitment to sustainable mobility has increased many folds. We are engaging with many stakeholders. We are trying to create change across the bodies, whether it is partnering with TV channels, whether it is partnering with newspapers. And the whole idea is that how can we bring sustainable mobility through Hero into this country? I just wanted to share the last video before I sign off. And this is what actually we want to achieve, this whole cycle of change, you know. If we can do that, nothing like it.
Give it a rest. It's never looked more beautiful.
It's our generation which has completely ruined the earth, you know, in a way, or the earlier generation. Now for the future generation, we have to educate them.
When plants, animals are going away like this, then we talking about city air is clean because I didn't start my car today is not ecological change, it's a civic change.
Expect people to think about these wonderful clean days that we've spent over the last few weeks and hope that we won't get back to our old bad habits.
One thing I say is, make way for bicycles, make way for more shade giving, make way for a much more comfortable way of riding.
Last but not the least, we sincerely believe Hero Cycles as a brand can create a mass movement about changing community habits. And we have the responsibility of creating a far greener, pollution-free world, not only for this generation, but for our future generations. Levin, I think, Levin said this, I remember his these famous words, keeps on echoing on my mind over the last few months, that there are decades when nothing happens, and then there are weeks when decades happen. This is so true for our category and for our brand. And therefore, our challenge as a brand for tomorrow is not only to sustain this consumer behavior towards cycling in general, but also multiply it manifold. Thank you. Thank you very much for listening to me. If there are any questions, I'm more than happy to answer. Thank you once again.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Rohit. It was awe-inspiring, the entire presentation and the thoughts that Hero has put behind Hero Cycles. And, you know, we've already seen during pandemic rise in cyclers, you know, even purchases, or rather a layman like me went on to buy a bicycle and couldn't get it because there was so much demand and less supply at that time. So, of course, we are seeing a rise change that we want to see. But do you think it's a sustained change? So here I would like to bring in an audience question which comes in for you, which says that globally studies have shown that consumers do not mind paying more for a brand whose purpose is defined and resonates with consumer values. India is a price-sensitive market. So do you think that Indian consumers will pay more for a product if the company has a clearly defined purpose? Now, this is true for Hero Cycles. So we would love to know from you.
I mean, in my mind, the answer is absolutely simple. As far as you're able to deliver value to the consumer, it's not about price. And value comes in various facets. Purpose is one of the many values you are delivering to your consumer.
Right.
Purpose is not the only value you're delivering to your consumer. But the purpose has a higher weightage than any other benefits you're offering. But if you are able to clarify to the consumer, or the consumer can resonate with your purpose, will he pay two times? Maybe not. But as far as you are able to give him value, and purpose is, in my mind, the overall arching value of that particular brand, there is no reason why a consumer will not pay for that.
Right. Absolutely. Another quick question the audience has put in, which says that many brands have in the past spoken about social issues in their larger context of brand purpose. However, in the recent past, we've seen that brands being targeted online. So with trolls, with questions on whether they're sticking to their guidelines, the brand values and the brand purpose. So which is the way forward in such cases?
I think we need to differentiate purpose and communication. The trolls, the reactions of consumers are primarily to a tactical things which brands are trying to do a short-term responsible behavior. If as a brand you are being true to your purpose, and that has nothing to do with COVID, COVID is only multiplying that weightage to your purpose, at least in our case,
right?
There is no reason why consumers are going to troll you. But if you're going to be super smart and trying to use some opportunity, then be ready for that. So
all right, now another question here, which I think brands will have a little insight to take from you here. In the production of cycles that Hero Cycles make, is Hero being sustainable? If so, then how?
Interesting question, and let me answer straight away. Yeah. We are trying to be sustainable. We are not 100% sustainable. Have we stopped use of plastic? The answer is no. Have we minimized use of plastic? The answer is yes. Are we taking care of all ethical issues of being social responsible? The answer is yes, because we are supplying to Europe, we are supplying to Indian markets. We are very, very, from an ethical standard perspective, we are very, very conscious. But are we 100% sustainable? The answer, for example, we are using trucks to transport a cycle from point A to point B, and therefore, in the process, are we giving it back the carbon emission? Our carbon score is not zero. So yes, we are trying. The new factory, for example, which we have just set up and is about to start production, that's again a completely different ball game. It's an absolutely green factory. I mean, I say absolutely green, not 100%, 99%. I mean, far higher green standards than what today my other factories are. So the intent is absolutely that if you want to be a brand which wants to do sustainable mobility, you as a product maker has to become absolutely sustainable first. So yes, a short answer, are we 100%? The answer is no, but are we improving? The answer is yes.
That's lovely to hear. So another quick question. Now this may be personal to a lot of this generation, as you called us, you know, who are trying to make that change in their lifestyle, have started seeing that once the lockdown was opened up, the traffic has come back, the cyclers have started moving away from the roads. So is Hero Cycles as a brand, as an organization, are making amends with government to create policies to have more cycling lanes, to have any policies like that in the future?
Yeah, we are doing some very, very specific interventions. And as I shared in my presentation, whether in terms of investment to co-create along with the government roads for cyclists separately. The government of India has, in the last 6 months, actually have created a larger body called Bicycle Development Council. It is headed by a secretary level bureaucrat. And in that Bicycle Development Council, there are many bureaucrats who are, let's say, people who are heading smart cities, commissioners who are setting smart cities, NGOs, many more bicycle ambassadors from each city. And that whole ambition there, actually, you know, if you ask me, one line agenda which I'm and we are trying as an organization from the government is that the so-called smart city has to have a dedicated lane for the cycle, There has to be some budgetary allocation for creating the cycling infrastructure. So yes, the intent is there from the government side, the intent is there from the bureaucrat side, the intent is there from the social bodies. And obviously as a brand, we are trying to anchor and create an ecosystem because absolutely right. I mean, when the roads were empty, we were all enjoying cycling. As the roads become much more, the traffic density increases, yeah. The cycling does not get the way of right in this country.
Right.
But I'm pretty confident that we'll get our way of right, provided all of us, including your generation, as you say, become party to this movement.
Absolutely. And we are looking forward to it, sir. And we are hoping that more brands like yours come forward and join this movement of change. So thank you so much for sharing your insights and story with us. E4M appreciates your time and effort, and all our viewers have taken, I'm sure, a lot of takeaways from your presentation. So thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Kathy. And thank you, everyone, for listening to me. Really appreciate it.